give me your name and your title.
Fred Grubb, founder, owner of Rocky Mountain Construction, along with my wife, Sue Ann.
You were thinking of this. What were your first, was this the final design or did you move into that?
No, Alan Schilke, who is a partner of mine, he came up with this real close the first time. And we presented it to Silver Dollar City and they accepted it. They liked it. And we've obviously put the first elements like this in any wood structure there is. Mm-hmm. So, and we're able to do this because of our track technologies. Yeah. So we've spent years developing this track and it's finally come about and it really works. It allows us to do these types of things.
How long was this in the making for you?
This particular coaster, we spent about 4 months designing and before we could dig a hole out here. So after they hired us, we spent about 4 months going back and forth, putting together the design, the finished design, and then we started digging holes. Yeah.
Do you have any other secret projects we don't know about that pop up?
We do. We do. I can't say what they are right now.
Of course.
But, of course. But, yeah, we're working on new stuff, new technologies, new things to
enhance the experience.
Enhance the wooden coaster, you know. So, yeah, this is. But this is one of a kind.
Yeah, it really
is. It's a first of a first.
Have you ridden it yet?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What'd you think?
It's great. Yeah. It's the best coaster I've ridden. Mm-hmm. So.
What was your favorite part?
I actually probably like the overbank turn at the end down there. So mm-hmm. The 153-degree bank. But I like it all. It's a good ride all the way throughout. So, and that's what we've tried to do is create a thrilling ride whole way, yeah. So we don't have dull moments. Mm-hmm. And we've also tried to create something that every age of person can ride, and they could go back and ride it again without fear, like they could only do it one time, so they can get back in line and go again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is there any element that you were kind of shaky about adding?
We knew that it can be done. It was hard to do for the first time, but we wouldn't have tried it if we didn't know it would work. So we knew it would work. But I gotta say, it's a job to put this together. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a job to put it together.
Before you died, you guys did mostly with New Texas Giant. You guys did just the track. This being your first real complete design, mm-hmm. What were the different challenges compared to just doing a kind of an overhaul of other rides?
Well, I guess there's obviously challenges. The site's tough. We tried to incorporate this site into the ride, where on the existing remodels, I guess you'd call it, of the coasters, everything's there for you. Mm-hmm. Here, we had to start with a blank palette and start from scratch. So many more medias to work with all the way through.
Iron Rattler, mm-hmm. Texas.
Yeah.
How was that project for you?
It's good. It's going to be another new great project.
We did twice.
It's going to be good. It's going to be really good. Now, it's going to be considered a steel coaster.
Yeah.
And we have really high hopes for it. The Giant, now that we've done, is rated 5. I think it's now went to number 3. On the steel coaster list. We have really high hopes for the Rattler. We've done some things with it that haven't been done either. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, so new stuff.
In terms of your next big project, is that becoming soon?
Yeah, yeah.
Very soon?
Yeah, we're in design right now, mm-hmm. And it's ongoing, so. Yeah.
Can you tell us a region?
I better let...
keep that on the low?
I better wait. I'll let you guys figure that out.
All right.
Yeah.
Do we have any other new technologies coming that we haven't seen yet?
Yeah. Yep. We do. We have new technologies that we're going to implement into the wood coaster structures, and they will be coming soon. Mm-hmm. And we've got new ideas all the time. Mm-hmm. We've got new track ideas. We've got new ideas coming.
Okay.
So they'll be out soon.
Oh, I can't wait.
There'll be more topper track coming in the real near future. Mm-hmm. So, yep, we're gearing up for the next round.
For people not familiar, is there anything that you would be best people, you should tell people about not having to worry about this, that this is a safe structure, that everything, mm-hmm. nothing bad is going to happen, it's not going to blow up?
Nope. No, it's safe, it's well designed. Like I say, the new track technologies, that's one of the reasons why we've developed the track, because in the past what we have done is we have went and reconditioned the traditional wood tracks. Mm-hmm. And we came up with this track because the wood tracks get rough, they don't last, it's a maintenance issue, and so that's why we developed our own wood track that will last. We offer a 5-year warranty on it. And so it'll continuously be this smooth, and obviously this is a smooth ride, you know, so it'll continuously be this smooth year after year. It helps parks out, so they don't have to continuously rebuild track, they don't have to hire companies like ours to come in and rebuild it.
Yeah, I do find that's definitely a big problem with a lot of wooden coasters. Mm-hmm. People don't want to invest in one because of so much maintenance. And that track technology definitely can mm-hmm. alleviate a lot of those problems.
And the technology allows us to do these kind of elements. Mm-hmm. So it is fully secure. We can put these elements, even different elements, in coasters now because of the track, where before we would not do it.
Yeah. Rocky Mountain, mm-hmm. where's it based out of?
Hayden, Idaho, way up north in the Panhandle. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's quite the drive.
Yeah, it's quite a trip. We're based out of there because it's a nice area, and we started in 2000, and all of our crew is from there, so we've elected to just continue to stay there. So that's where our company's based out of, and that's where our manufacturing shops are at. And one thing, so we've spent years rebuilding coasters. We've built coasters for other companies. We worked on El Toro. We worked all over the country working on tracks and stuff. And we now, you know, manufacture all our own parts and everything out of those shops. We build most everything in-house. So we don't farm out much work. We build even the cars. We build. We have our own machine shops. We build all our own parts. In fact, we do everything except for the fiberglass on.